Thank you for coming. I'd like you to join me in welcoming Kempo Sutrum Lodro to Otterbein University. Kempo was born in 1961. He ordained as a monk at a young age, and in the early 80s, in 1984, he began studying at Laurangar Monastic University. At the time, this was a fairly new institution in the eastern Tibetan province of Kham. And over the course of 8 years, he progressively studied until he achieved the degree of Kempo, roughly the Tibetan equivalent of the US PhD. In 1991, he became the abbot of Sirta Laurangar, the monastery where he had been studying. For the last 21 years, I just learned today that he retired last year, but for 21 years, he guided the development of this institution. Under his leadership, Laurangar grew into the largest monastic institution in the Buddhist world. The estimates vary, but I've heard reliable guesses of anywhere between 20 and 40,000 monks and nuns, all in residence at one time. As its abbot, Kempo Sutrum Lodro has had a profound influence on the development of Buddhism inside Tibet. He has used this influence to guide the development of Buddhism and insisting that Buddhist ideas be relevant to contemporary society. He's been a strong advocate for the education of women, for the preservation of the environment, and also for vegetarianism. Tonight, the Kempo will discuss the question of Buddhism and economic development with us. And please join me in welcoming Kempo Sutrum Lodro.
Ni ngaco sota chemo gigan namba dang ni loma namba tamchella shuto dela kan samtjigin.
Good afternoon, good evening to all the students and teachers who have gathered here this evening.
Tini terang ngaco dana mma mampun tini zom ni ngaco thama kadashi tini di koskup yaboshong orang ngang pegaboshong song.
I'm really happy to have the chance to engage in conversation with you all here.
Tini derang atso tini khabda nangton khabshang de tini shusokun phelgi nangda tini ngatso nangba ge samlo tini shikin phanto kandis thomato deri.
And the topic of our conversation tonight is going to be about the effect, the influence, and the benefit of Buddhist thought or Buddhist ideology on social development.
Tani terang ne namba thamala tani ngostu jiat kangrezina zo nga zo bog tani namba sangje ba tani kucho tani shusong pelge thola tani tashtang tawa tisone nge namba thola tani ngostu jigri.
The focus of the thoughts I'm going to share with you tonight are really the Tibetan Buddhist attitude or approach to social development from a Buddhist point of view.
Tani boba zena tani sacha tani hajang tani musarwa tani zala tani neoba tani murg tani zri.
When we talk about Tibetan people, we're referring to a people who really are in some ways quite special and unique.
Tani sacha musarwa ti thola yo pi tani murg tela yang tani rigni yang tani ga yang musarwa tani ziore.
And because this people lives in a special place, they've also developed a culture that is in many ways quite special.
Tani rigni tela korang murg rang rigni dang tani chu rigni te tani ni yore.
And when we talk about Tibetan culture, Tibetans have their own culture as well as a religious culture.
Tani chu rigne de tarta ji ha jang ja ja chimbu jang de ni chu de tani lo tong ta chig da sum ja gung ne tani jagar ne tani shong bare.
And this pervasive religious culture originated about 1300 years ago in India.
Tani bobala sanglo tamba yena tani lo tong cha chig da tani samja tani zga rangla tani mo rigpa samo tani la pa tangmo Tendi gudini mu tsangma di tini korang tso gudini chu di tola tini zhimjik mambu shini tini shindu.
And this religious culture was developed in Tibet as a result of, at that time, 1,300 years ago, the most erudite and intelligent members of the population really applying themselves to this religious tradition, researching and investigating it very diligently.
What
Tibetans over their traditional history were really applying their efforts in research and thinking too were not how to do business or how to improve the economy, how to make money or things like this.
Then he calls so the Koranto Jimjik Shisa, the Gala Jimjik Shay, the Zinga, so Mula Jimjik Shay, Yori.
What they really were concerned about investigating was the human.
Then he Murray and not any Murray Lipota, Murray Lipo on any trapons in a Shijunje, a Tisikorati Jimjik Mambushi, Munduk, so what they marry.
But when we talk about investigating the human, it really wasn't research into the physical nature of the human being, bacteria and cells and things like this. In respect of their interest in the human, there were two things that they paid most attention to. The first of these was the human life or human life force. And the second was the human mind. So it says a result of their efforts in researching, investigating, and conducting experiments into the nature of the human mind and the human life as it were, that the Tibetan tradition developed special or unique views or findings on these subjects of inquiry.
In
terms of the human life or consciousness, there are many ideas or views that are held by the tradition, the Tibetan tradition, which are probably not found anywhere else in the world. So for this reason, the Tibetan attitudes to the mundane world, to the value of human life, and other areas of human value were also shaped and influenced by the Tibetan interest in the human life and the mind. So in respect of the traditional Tibetan attitude towards progress or development, there were three key ways or areas in which progress was conceived of. So these days, nowadays, whether it's the West or in the East in Asia, most people when they speak of development or progress, and this is spoken of a lot, really what people are chiefly referring to is economic development. If we ask ourselves whether social development is characterized by the continual improvement of our living standards, then we cannot say that this is not one form of progress or development, but to let this characterize the entire way that we define progress is indeed mistaken. From a Tibetan traditional point of view, the first kind of progress that we can speak of is progress of the mind or progress of one's ideas and attitudes.
Tani ngatsu tarstan rabo ina ngatsu nafshuk la tini semkhum rikpa yori, shafshuk la semkhum rikpa yori, shirta ngatsu sem la tini jimjik shibata shir mambu ndugus.
In today's world, whether it's in the East or the West, there's a lot of people conducting research into the psychology of the human mind. Yet, while there's a lot of research conducted into the various functions or manifestations of the human mind, there's not necessarily a great deal of penetrating research done into the fundamental essence of what that mind actually is. When we talk about happiness or pleasure in life or suffering and pain in life, chiefly these things are decided by our minds. In saying this, however, I'm not saying that in order for a person to be happy, all they need to do is resolve issues at the level of their mind and they don't need anything else. That's not what's being said. In order for us to be happy, or happiness indeed relates to a lot of needs, but among these needs, chief among them, is the needs of our mind. So in respect of the direction that society takes, social direction, whether or not this is a healthy direction or an unhealthy direction, this really rests on the minds of the and the attitudes of the influential people in a given society. Over the course of human history, and including recent human history, the wars and great conflicts that we've seen are the result of those with power and privilege not having a proper direction in terms of their minds.
Then do you think that's a must to get control of the motive for your own in Nanda? That's on Zambalong Ship, good in Zambalong Jivdi lay in Nanda. Ganga Tola in Nanga, so must so sim the Halibay embodied in it, sim thing as what any Garchishu Shigris, you know, thing as some other Shigris.
So whether we're talking about the very great, large kind of macro level of the world at large, and whether or not we will obtain world peace, or the micro level of the individual human life, then the issue of mind is extremely important.
Tani ngatsu maashi paade kaareze na taro ngatsu te maayin biti ni sem koranga nang la, te koranga khtang la, tani ngatsu tsama ga maashi biti ni khsangwa hajang mambondus.
The reason, however, that people have not known really about the nature of the human mind is that in many ways what lies at its innermost core seems like a great secret to us.
A
great deal of the research that humans have engaged in up until this point has been research oriented outside of ourselves, outside oriented to the external world or to subjects outside ourselves. Very little has focused introspectively or inwardly on our minds. It can't be denied that a great deal of scientific research dedicated to researching the external world and physical phenomena, matter, etc., has indeed obtained great results. However, the amount of research effort that has been directed to understanding our minds has been considerably less.
Then you got some low niche tambang rang las, low niche sunchula, then you tsang bang, then you labada, then you wang sadang, wang sadang in the shenji, or the so latini, then you same got all latini, jimjikshi, then go to your is low niche rang la.
Over the past 20 years or so, scientists have started to do research into the mind by looking at things like the functioning of the brain, looking at nerves and how they respond, etc.
Ngama latuna tini, ngama lo nyishi ngon latuna tini, titola yadye mambo tini shong dos.
So from the point of view of where we were, say, 20 years ago, where we are now, yes, we've seen some kind of progress.
Yinayang tini koranzo wo tini, jimjik shi tanga tini, namba moshi, moshi zina. Jimjik shi tanga tini, namba tini, tini nanggang duze, tini nanggang yopi jimtsinji, tarta gawarta, sim gaksangwa ngoma tini, taro hako yo maris.
However, the mode by which this research is being carried out entails a certain degree of risk. And the reason for this risk is that still the internal nature of the mind or the secrets of the mind are still not properly understood.
Tini tanga su tini sem ka sawa de nguni tani shana sem ka sawa de chi kar chi shuri te ha ko go ya zuri te ko suna tini te nga su yargi tong jin du si te sem de yargi tana yargi ja chim bu tong jiwa res.
So it's really important that the secrets of the mind or the secret of the mind be understood, be known. And it's really only after we can understand this that we will be able to speak about progress and development in any real sense. Just as we, through formal education, move on from elementary school to middle school to high school, etc., and with each stage increase our understanding and learn things that we previously didn't, we need to continue in this direction and continue to progress in our understanding. If we're going to understand what it means to be human, then we need to see humans as being comprised of half mind and half matter or form.
Then you got some mutti, then you shake out the mupo, tini ungupu de korang la tini gumko kongo re yang sem la yang korang korang tini yang gumko yore te korang kongo re ti gumko de kongo re ma to te kong ma ta na pe na nga cho ungupu zupo pe na nga cho mu ta na wa ta tini pe na lipo tini gupa te yang ta pa kong ma ta na nga cho la lipo la dung re yong re tini sem go gupu gumko de kong ma ta na sem go to la dung re yong de us.
So given the fact that we are made up half of, you know, material form and half of mind, we have needs in respect to both of these aspects of ourselves. So just as not being able to fulfill the needs of our physical being, like the need to breathe, for example, has great harm on our body, so too not fulfilling the basic needs of our mind has great harm and danger for our being.
Deni pena ngaran sommos chigla samlo tamba yena deni phoa trina zamazar gore kharkum na chinthong gore deni changna khagna deni komba gong gore tezo tamje pong aso ngupo deni murang ngupo deni gumkho de par deni gongji de res.
So the fulfillment of physical needs are obvious things like needing to eat when we're hungry, drink when we're thirsty, wear clothes when we feel cold.
Deni da ngupo deni gumkho de deni changma drip chari ji se pe nanga cho za ji yang yo gonje yang yo thongje yo yo deni do sa khang ba yang yo langkor yang yo de chu cham po yo chari ji se deni da nga cho sem go gumkho de yang ko rang sang lo tang go re.
And after these physical and material needs are satisfied, the aforementioned needs and things like needing to have a place to dwell, a form of transport, etc. Once these are satisfied, then we need to begin to think about the needs of our minds.
Deni karti ti kavsanga so ngupo deni lipo lipo na nga so ngupo deni te dopa to kangje te ma to pa deni sem gun dopa kangje te nga so par kir jana deni nga so mola deni sem gu to ne ya pe na zaji me pa ta konji me na lipo to la dungur yong wa jind sem korang la yang deni korang ga zama zi yore zi te me na deni sem gu to ne dungur mo yong gu dus.
So just as if we didn't attend to one of our basic physical needs, like needing to eat or drink, then not attending to the needs of our mind results in our mind being in a state akin to hunger or a state akin to thirst, a state of great suffering.
Deni tin sondi nga zo deni ta ta sim ge tok te la yang pe na jim jik she ki ta sim ge tok la chor ta she ki ta sim yar gi se tong ji ta hali ba gar chim bo re.
So for this reason, it's very important to do research into the mind, to do experiments into the nature of the mind in order to obtain a better understanding.
Deni pena nga cho tartan ta boyin nan zamolang ge sharsho ge nan nursho ge na nga cho lobja chim bo mang chi wa zga nang la chama ge deni ganglan dang jap ge yor zina nga cho rigni lobji te lan dang jap ge de shiun lobji te lan dang jap ge de deni chung kan ri jap ge re deni nga cho tindig ko ra gormo mambo kandi sa gore tindig tindig ko ta ma to ba nga so sim ko ko tela mambo mambo samlo tang ga yomares.
So whether it's in Western countries or in Asia, probably most university students think that what they need to be thinking about and paying attention to is studying culture, studying knowledge, how to make money, how to get a job, and perhaps relatively few would be thinking about the needs of their mind.
Deni karte nga chun zambalang ga lhota chi mo ha chang ga deni shusok tog la shikini yo sa zambalang ga tog la shikini yo sa ga lhota chi mo ndo so ga deni ngupo chikpo ma tog ba nga chun mo ga deni ngupo ga cha shi ta deni ta ga din dopa drip ki ta ta ma tog ba sem gun dopa drip ki te la samlo ma tang sem yar gi sa tong wa la samlo ma tang na deni nga chun ma ong ba na halipa ga kangar mambo dam cha sa res.
However, if our universities and particularly our influential universities are really committing their energies only to the research or advancement of the material world, then the direction of our social development will be greatly compromised.
Deni nga cho sim yar gi se tong zya ta sim jung dr shi zya te so tham ji bo chang ma sam da o te chulu ka ka ja re sam na te ma re zi te chulu ka ka ja z ma re.
So when we talk about the improvement of the mind or the development of the mind, the training of the mind, a lot of people might think dismissively that this is, you know, religious talk.
Tani ngarang tsu mus tang se yin na, pe na korang chulg la tapa yung ken yin na dha, meng ken yin na dha, yang na sanji ge chula tapa shen ken, yeshi ge chula tapa shen ken yin na dha. Mus tang se yin na, tani ngarang tsu kashi, ngarang tsu tini zhipchak chik di, tani ngubo yin ba tang, zhipchak chik di, tani to ngarang tsu go tani sem yin ba di, ngarang tsu keleng go gore, di tsangma dhawa dhata rizhi, mu tsangma chik ba rizhi.
However, regardless of what a person's religious faith may be, or even indeed whether a person has a religious faith or not, everyone can't but accept that humans are comprised by material, the material on the one hand, and the mind on the other.
Tendri yindi tini nga tso tini taga sim tila tini yondr shi gore, penna nga tso lipo la tini yondr ma shi na nga tso lipo nda tini, te kale kale nat rama rama mambo yong gore, nga tso mambo go yondr yang shi kaya ores. Pe tevjin da tini nga tso sim la yang tini yondr shi gore, ma to sim la yondr ma shi na, tini sim go tola nat mambo yong gore.
So just as we need to exercise and train our bodies, lest they become ill and attacked by disease, so too we need to train and exercise our minds so they don't develop illnesses.
Tani nga tso tarta nga tso tini sim ge thola tini zambolan ge thola chamche po kana ye na re tini Europe American da so sama yang dan da re sim ge thola na to ha le ba mambo yong gen de ti na ne pe na chap chi shu shi de kang re je na tini nga tso tong ser ge na yi yu zhe tong ser ge na te je je pe na tin da wa zhe ge zamba yang mambo de zhe.
So, particularly in Europe and America, but all over the world, mental illness is increasing everywhere. And among these illnesses, one of the most severe is depression.
Tani tongser ke nad tani yong go wijim sen te chi gan re zena chi tinga tso tani leka go shawa go non shi ha chang chi chi wijim sen ji res.
One of the reasons for the increase in depression is due to the stress and pressure that we incur in our everyday lives and jobs.
Then nga chu shaba no sing de di mambo yong wi gimsen ka re zena, then nga chu chuwa ha chang mir chi ba, sheng ho jie zou kuai. Nga chu chuwa da ha chang mir chi wi to gre se, myok chi wi to gre de se.
And one of the reason that our working lives generate so much stress and pressure is linked to the extremely fast pace of our lives.
Tani nga tso tsowa ge tani te ge ndo tani ze mir go wi gem tsen che re ze nga tso ti tsu tong tong go na la le ka mambo le go le ka mambo ndrup go tani ge ndrup go wi gem tsen de ka re ze na tani nga tso mo ge ndo pa la te yo re ze.
The reason for why we have this pressure, this need to accomplish so much in such a short period of time, is essentially to do with the desires of the human mind.
Tani nga rang tso per na tartan rapo yin na nga tso zambalang de kandri zi re zi na per na sunkur chilun. O tani gyartung chumbam mambo go tani chikar chikur chikar chikur wi tani chircha chimbo tawa chikirin du si tartan nga tso zambalang de.
The way our world works at the moment is like one great big water wheel.
Tani tin chircha chimbo toga tani khorlo tso chikar chikur chikar chikur ondi tani nga tso tina nin khorlo chikni zi khashi zin khor masam na yang khor go gore man khor na yang tab shi mandu zambalang de tani lo ni sama leka mambo le go tani shawa mambo drup go tisot thong thong go nang la drup go leka sama mgyok bo drup go tani sama zambalang shi tani rin do ondi wuse.
Or like all the internal cogs spinning inside a great big machine. That's the way the world is at the moment, and if one cog is spinning, so do the other cogs turn in response. This is the way that our interlinked world seems to be working.
Then it team jevet kanthe je na ngatso sama ga te ngatso ji yarje tong ju shisog yarje tong je ga te ni mir te yang go res.
And the reason that it is happening like this is because we see this as part of the development and progress of society.
Rete yena nga tsu mu tsama ge tini ndopa moderation de ndopa tini cha chen bo tini je tini moderation de ndopa chen bo re song ti tini morere ge langkor mambo khamba mambo sa cha chen bo tini thong khong mambo pe shu tang tini she na tini ga ta ra nga tsu sa ko la chi ma tong me du te yena tini mu tsama ge tini ndopa de tini yar ge tang jang na tini tha ji tini sa ko la chi bo de nga tsu mu tsama ge ndopa khang jo wa tini ji yong thup ge man du ge.
However, the result of all of these spinning cogs, the ever-increasing size of our desires, the need to constantly acquire things, whether that be a bigger house or cars or a greater material standard of living, is that we rapidly exhaust the Earth's resources. We only have one world, and it will not sustain this kind of increasing desire forever.
되니 사고라고 토나 요비드니 그런 거 돈 돈쿵 능유엔 돈쿵도 되니 가서 먹었더니 즉보다 응보 어떤이 높아도 좋게 좋아시나 때 그런 건 접탑 그래서 사고라고 통콩도 가서 먹었더니 응보 차 자기다 견교 더 좋아시나 뒤 니바다 사고라라 요래 된단 그래서
If we were just talking about the basic needs of our humans, what our basic needs are, then the world, in fact, does possess the resources to satisfy these.
갈등아츠사골라가통나요비
However, if we expect the world to, or the earth to be able to provide sufficient resources to satisfy all our every desires, considering that there is absolutely no end to how great and immense our desires may grow, then even if we had 5 worlds or 10 worlds, it still wouldn't be enough.
더니 탄 용용장건 소화끼고 전에 된지 제제가 요래 잠몰한테 제가 요래 다 이나가서 쇼크증이가 좀 높아 야기 타나 되니 뜻소 탐시 본 접지요 말이스
So whilst on the one hand everybody these days seems to be talking about environmental protection leading simple or simplified lives low carbon lifestyles etc without a concomitant reduction in our basic desires, then we will be in no way be able to accomplish this goal of environmental protection. Of the 7 billion people alive on the planet, there is almost no one who doesn't aspire to the standard of material living of the world's most affluent and richest people.
Garting also the ni mat tongshir chul tongshir dunche thambati the ni darta ga mushik po chog the ni chowa tawa the ni zikir gona the ni also sakola simni runga gvar yogo undus.
However, if all of these people were, in actual fact, to enjoy this standard of living, then we would need perhaps 3 or 5 times our existent world. But of course, this is impossible. We only have one world. So for this reason, it's necessary that we adjust our desires in relation to the amount of resources that are in actual fact available to us.
And
what this entails is essentially bringing our desires into some measure of control.
되니 찬증 간티시고 오래지나 가서 배나 가랑서 되니 가서 무보스지라 하장 되니 가위 내르거나 되니 배나 가랑서 랑코르스지라 할레파 강아서 심근나라 할레파 가위 내르거나 되니 쿄랑텔라 마르가지니 텐디시고나 되니 로소 잡난다 잠보시난다 춤장난다 간타랑 되니 또 손준시 톱고 말이지
However, in terms of bringing these desires into control, if we attempt to impose or to curtail these desires at a point when we're feeling absolutely infatuated with a particular object, like a fancy car or something, we're really in the height of desire or infatuation or enrapture with a particular object. Then trying to curtail our desires at this point is not going to come to much.
너니 다 찬증시나 간티시고 제나 페나 나랑 랑코르치라 하창 가니 나랑 테니 텐디 데요니 그나 테니 네 카르티 텔레 삭피 텔레 텔레 장위 랑코르즈 테니 네 르그잖아 Tiri nga rang langkor tila gandro go res, langkor chibbo tila nga te tsantzin ngin doba tsa tsantzin shitab go res, tili zangwa, tili lhapaz tini ngay thong song na, tini nga rang gsemte tila gandro go res, langkor zyamba tila tini nga gagama res.
Really, the only way that we would be able to bring or change that desire, the nature of that desire, would be if all of a sudden there were available to us an even better car, for example, in which case we would shift our desire to that and then cast the former one out of our consideration. So unfortunately, if humans are unable to appreciate anything other than affluent lifestyles, cars, houses, etc., as being signs of progress and development, then it will be impossible for us to bring our desires under control. So, in order to obtain happiness, we're not saying that these things are not part of it, or are not to be considered, or are not important. However, what we do need to appreciate is that there is a kind of happiness that exists beyond this. So the sensorial pleasures that things like eating food or traveling or, for some people, drinking wine bring us are a result of the stimulation that they bring to our senses. What we really need to investigate for ourselves is whether there is, in fact, any other happiness than that which we receive through various kinds of stimulation of our physical or, you know, sensorial selves.
Then you can't think that's a sim go sawa, me sim go sawa, the shisuna, that's all a lamka hachang mambunduzi, that's all dishit.
If we are to understand, or if we in fact do understand the secret of the mind, then there becomes many potential paths and roads to happiness that will open up for us. For the time being, though, we're not saying that eating, drinking, and the other kinds of material pursuits that we regularly engage in are not necessary. Of course, they
are.
We, of course, eating, for example, or other kinds of actions that we engage in are fundamental to our survival. But then, after we've used these means to secure our survival, then what do we do? Then to what do we turn our attention? All of these questions that we've been asking are ones that we need to one by one ask ourselves.
jima maung ba rang rang ge leka ge ton da shawa ge ton da re sam ge yo re.
However, for the majority of people who are in universities, most of students' thoughts are really about their work and their careers and what they're going to do after graduating.
Then if shawa drip ki to kare re nga so shawa drip go wi jimsen kang re zina then nga so gormo go yo re ti ton da re.
And the reason that we in fact have to pursue careers or work is because we need to make money.
Then nga so gormo go wi jimsen ta kang re zina then nga so chogni shi ta ba we le sheng chun zhe nga so chogni shi ti bi jimsen ji re zina nga so ten di lang jab ge re.
And then if we're going to answer the question of why we need money, the answer would be because we need money in order to survive, in order for our livelihoods.
Then nga so chogni de chi ge dong da re zina zhe yong na then nga so mo mo bo zhe ge dan dan lang jab shi ge ma re.
But then if we press the question further and ask, well, why do we even need to survive? Why do we need to survive? Then, in fact, many people would come up blank against this. They wouldn't have an answer. And if the answer we give to the question of why we need to survive is, well, of course we need to survive. We need to survive in order to survive. If that's what we end up answering, then essentially we're proposing an idea of survival which is without any goal or objective. And indeed, if we our survival of our lives are without goals or objectives, then we essentially live in a very empty way.
Then nga cho ge sim tong ba re song na tin nga cho she lo ni nga cho ngu bu ya ge tang ni khang ba yeg bo yo lang ko yeg bo yo za ma yeg bo yo gong ba yeg bo yo na ya sim tong ba yan sar ti tin nga cho sim ge na la sim ya ge ro ma to na tin dung mo ma bo zo yong ge us.
So if our minds, if we're empty in our minds, then irrespective of how wonderful our external material world may be, how fancy our car might be, how comfortable our house might be, with an empty mind and an empty heart, then we will live in great suffering.
Then the ending at the Gormu Mambo, then you Sarne, Gormu Mambo Sarne, then you Zama, Jimbo Zayata, Gomba Yapotunia, then at the Gotin in Tsone, Muir de Maris, Shumsun the Moody, the Maris.
Eating delicious food, piling up a lot of savings, investing highly in our external material lives, these are not the real reasons for our survival or why we need to survive.
Deni pe na nga chor langkhor zula san lo tam ba yena deni langkhor ko na la lok go re nim go re chir go re de so tham chi put ni langkhor ti na ta khorang ga tin chog ne ga ton da res we la shung chen langkhor khorang ga chog ne ga ton da res.
If we think about it in terms of a car, for example, then adding water and petrol, etc., to it and giving it what it needs is essentially answering the basic survival needs of the car. But nobody would say that the goal of the car's survival is to consume and digest gasoline.
Then you lankur kumir the num chakjeta, num meba shikiti marese, one akar is in a koranga lekas lake, the koranga mugir, koranga gubati teres.
Of course, the true function of the car is really what it performs for us, what it does. It's not about the fuel that it consumes.
Then you also mustila samlotana, then you also zamazajeta, kujunjeta, lankur korjeta, kambagana la dejeta, so pena lankurka. Deni korang nam ta chidang deni korang lok ta jabore de nga chu de chu me na nga chu de thab ko mare nga chu ndug thab ko mare langkhori na chi me lok me na me na korang sha wa shi thab ko mare de jan jan da res.
And we as humans are exactly the same. As a car needs its water and gasoline and whatever or not to function, and so too do we need our food and our material surrounds place to live in, etc. Because without these things, then our basic survival would not be sustained.
Then you langkhor yin na, then you korang ka, then you log dang, chi dang, then you to num to so tham che pon zoom ne korang then you chog ne shi tar yu ji ne, ta korang ka chog ne ka nyang bong ngoma to, then you to ta jiao tong gong ju zhen na, then you zhim zhir ka, then you to ta xia wa le ka le ji te re zhi.
Of course, the real purpose of a car is after it has its functioning needs have been satisfied, its real use is as a means of transport.
The entire thing of Munda in that in Aso Ranga Zamazaya, the Kambana and the Gitan Tenichi, the Nita, the Mubula Longshu Shiket, the Ningazo Muzukit in Tornig and Yambo Maris, Tornig and Murti Maris, Shavajans of Goris.
So, as humans, our primary, the essence of why we're here and what we need to do is not to consume these basic things that we need for our survival.
Then you shall. And
what this other thing is, or in fact what this meaning is that is superior or transcendent to our basic needs of survival can be understood as two things. So the first of these things, benefiting others, or doing things that are of benefit to others, can be understood as helping other people, people who are in less fortunate situations, people who are poor, people who are in need. And the knowledge and skills that we learn in universities today are not ends in themselves, they're mere tools towards other objectives. How we use these tools in the future, to what ends we deploy them, is something that we use our minds to determine. So without development in our mind, progress in our mind, then all of the skills and knowledge, these tools that we have cultivated over the course of our education, could be used in ways that are of harm not only to ourselves but also to others. But if we are able to really develop our minds, to progress our minds, then using our minds in tandem with the skills of knowledge and technical skills that we've developed, then we'll be able to use them in ways that are of benefit to ourselves and to others as well. So, for example, a person who spends many years studying in a business school, for example, studying how to do business, etc., and then eventually one day becoming extremely rich. Well, money in itself is ultimately a material thing like anything else. It's not inherently good or bad. Indeed, the use to which it's put, ultimately its value is determined by the mind of the person to whom it belongs. So understanding that this logic or understanding this way that things operate, we need to appreciate the value of developing and improving our minds. And not dismiss it as something that belongs to the realm of religion, insofar as we all have a mind and it comprises a large part of our being, then its development is a matter for everyone and a matter for the individual person and not in a matter intrinsically for religion. So as you know, very few people would say that training the body or keeping it fit is a religious matter. So too, training and keeping our minds fit is a matter for the individual, and it's something to which we need to really devote due attention.
Garting aso tini simkum gutini detang te latini dabo yakbo magibna tini aso sobjagna ni lojong ya poshi tabko mare shuso ko thola sone tini lega ya yakbo le tabko mare.
If we don't pay attention to the health of our minds, then we won't be able to do well in our studies, we won't be able to study well, we won't be able to work well, we won't come of good in many of the activities we engage in.
Then America got any sobta chimbo khashi nala then ta lomma deni jacha jipchi jerna de then tonsir gna ba yi yitren tonsir gna ba rendus.
Statistics say that in some American universities as much as 45% of students have or suffer from depression.
Then it tonsir gna ba de rendu gimtsin ta rezena de nga so nunshing damra nga so lota chimbo nala yona pe na lota chimbo nala yondi me mambo zo khorang so tini lota jamba gna ni ang tambo shi ni tini lota din nala yong wari din nala nga so lota gna ni ang tambo ta ta nyam de jer jer ti tini chama ang tambo ren do mari din nala ang tambo ni pa sam ba je pa nga pa ti yondi tini so so se ma ki pa shi ni tini mambo zo tin ji ren do ndu.
And in some cases, this is due to the fact that there is a great deal of pressure and stress in universities for students who aspire to be the best among their peers, and when everybody is aspiring to be the best, not everybody can be, and so students feel a great deal of suffering due to their inability to compete. And due to this competition between people, we experience a great deal of suffering.
Pena nga tsum mu mambo zu kusam lo ta na kanti ri zina ta ngarang pena nga tsum mu chi thamba yo na nga tsum mu chi ti na ni ti ni ngarang ti ni chi ti ni chi lo jung go thone ye na kang go thone ye na ti ni zang shu te re song na ne nga tsu to sim ha jung bo ti ni chek yo re gar ti jamba tsu le te zu yan song na ne nga tsu sim chek yo ma re te pan chen jin zheng.
Many people will think that, say, if among 10 people they are quite well off in terms of their study performance or in other areas of life, then they'll feel quite satisfied. But if they're somewhat below the standard of others, then they will feel agitated. And so this is the result of competitive feeling.
Tene pena nga tsu chu go lobda nga ne lojong shi bine kem na tin jan tsu te yori zeng nga rang lo chung go kap se nga tsu lojong shi bine kem na tin jan tsu te yo nyong je.
Even in terms of Kempo's own studies in the religious context in a monastery, there was also this kind of competition between students.
Tene nga tsu go lobda nga la yo jig mangbo tra go re mo mangbo yo re tene chabar to tsuba mangbo jab go re tene she yong de tene tsuba jab na tene nga tsu mo khashi go tsopa jabna ti tharko la mo tong chang mambo te ni tamo ta yo re de ri shi ti ti na ne yang bo ma yong na te ni sem ga na la ma ke ba yong re.
In this context, there's a great deal of examinations, there's a great deal of tests, and in particular, a great deal of debate. And when people engage in the debating courtyard, there are often thousands of spectators looking on. So if a person who's engaging in debate doesn't do well, then they feel a great sense of discomfort.
Then it takes a lot of carries some goes in a same market persona, then penang around some mochi or not, tin on in a zanshu in a karchimbo mareze nga so mochi ga nani nga zangshu yinda nga dikshu yinte karchimbo mareze tena kangreze na nga so mochi ga nani nga zangbo yinda da nga dikbo yinda da nga rang rang ge loso da nga rang rang ge lojong da de tini nga rang rang ge mase tong dang dang ba yong mo jan la phan to ba so so rang de che dang dang ba zi yona te karchi wa re ma to ba nga yamba da nga ni dir na jan li nga lhagba de karchimbo mare samle nga so tindi sam ge te sam na pe phan to yong ge ndus.
However, at that time, a very beneficial thought was thinking that my studies and my performance is really an issue for me. My own improvement and my own progress is, in fact, a matter of my individual concern. Whether or not I'm among 10 people considered the best or not so good, it's really not a question of comparing myself to others.
Tarta mambo tendi mareze nga tsope nam nyip chi ona nyip chi ti nani nga nga rang go lojung de tani mo jamba gupo ti le nga rang zang song na tani nga sem ke bore ndo ore ma to ba nge nga rang mo chi go nani nga rang tani ang tam bore song na ti ma ong ba na nge pan to da ma to jamba la pan to ma to nga rang rang la pan to ma to te nga tson dang jab go mareze ga tar mo chi ti nani nga ang tam bore song na ta nga sem ke go ore ze tani ti jing sen ben duk se.
But a lot of people really don't put a lot of emphasis on the intrinsic value in their own individual education. They think their source of happiness or satisfaction comes from being the best among 10 students. And in fact, they're really, in thinking this way, and not really considering the benefit, for example, that they're going to put their achievements to or the way that they're going to help others.
Tene shirta nga tson jandir zige de de jinjang zige de shir tsawa ne yo mnyam ba zmare to chong zu yo go gres.
Of course, we're not disavowing here the value of competition in some situations. It is in some amount necessary.
Ina ti ta ta la sam lo tang jang na tene nga tso sim market ba lo ne thama nga tso sim na pa rin rong dos.
However, if we think only about this, then our minds will become very ill.
Tendi yendi tini nga tsu tsangma ga tini lobja ga na la yo bi ne ka phoma tso yo na samlo ya bo tang ni nga rang rang ga tani mtsi ton dang dam ba ti kang ti che go re gang la mtsi ton dang dam ba ze ga re sam ni ti la samlo tang go re.
So for this reason, everybody in the university today, students really need to think very hard about the value of their life and what they want to do of meaning with this life.
Tani nga rang tsum mambo zika, ta nga kachak dang damba re song na, nga tani gulmo mambo yo pa shikbo re song na, yang na nga wangcha chenbo yo pa tindi re song na, tani nga dekhi damba yung go re, nga rang ka mase te tong dang damba re sa ni samba te, ta chor jing ka samlo tawa, samlo nyangba tawa re, nga tsum mambo zika nga ma ni san dewa te re si.
But if people think that their happiness is going to come from fame or from riches or from status or privilege, then this is a very outdated, obsolete way of thinking.
Then it this some lor nyang ba ti sam chir to nga so la dekh ki yong ge me ba ta 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 nga zo tir mi shi tsa chi ba na la thon ju ti ni ma mang bo zo ge ni ta ta ha go yo re.
And the fact that this kind of thinking is obsolete and outdated is something that many people in the 21st century realize.
Then the yin ti nga zo lam kha sar wa ta thab shi sar wa zo la ten ni nga zo su so rang ge ti ni ma si dekh ki dang dang ba ta deni shi so la mo jan la pan ba yong ya ge tabshi tindi ayo moyo ta go gres.
So many people realizing this, what we really need to do is to build or to forge a new path or road to happiness and to benefiting others.
Deni ti indi ti tabshi de ayo zena tabshi yo gres tabshi de gan re zena so so sim ya ge ta na de res.
So in looking to whether there is such a road or in looking to how we could forge this path, then or perhaps even asking the question of whether it exists, the answer is it certainly does, and the answer lies in developing and improving our own minds.
Then is sem yarje tawaz ji de kan rizla ze ge ze ne na pe na nga so mo chang ma dar tan da bo yin nga so so nga rang rang de de mo ke bo yon na sam ne tin ri ma to ba mo jam ba de mo yon na sam ji de nga so sem ga na la ha jang nyung nyung res.
But in respect of improving and developing our own minds, there are many people who in the present day still do not think mainly about how they're going to help others and be of benefit to others. Their thoughts for the most part, revolve around themselves. So if we had a choice of very comfortable and luxurious transport methods, say boats and airplanes and cars, etc., then everybody would choose the means, or almost everybody would choose that means that was most comfortable for themselves. And in fact, everybody would head towards whichever method, means of transport that was. If, for example, flying in business class was something that didn't require a lot of money and there were no limitation on seats, then there would be very few people, it would seem, who would say be willing to give up their seat to other people. And the same selfish logic pertains also in terms of regions where we live. So those areas that are safe and those areas that are unsafe. Of course, we want to live in the area that's safe, and as for the unsafe areas, therefore other people. But conflict inevitably ensues from this situation where every single individual is relentlessly pursuing their own ideal of happiness. And in order for ourselves to be victorious and to vanquish our opponents, we deploy a lot of the fruits of our knowledge and our skills, and we consume and waste a lot of resources.
And
countless numbers of weapons are used, and we create wars and conflicts, and a great deal of suffering results in the world.
And
the essence of all of this is our own basic selfishness. Of course, to think about one's own happiness or to wish for one's own happiness is not mistaken.
However,
if we really become very tightly attached to our own happiness, then what ultimately results is the unhappiness of others. So for this reason, at the level of our minds, we really need to train ourselves in the aspiration of benefiting others. In terms of we humans, there are many, many respects in which our thoughts and actions are grievously mistaken.
Tendri shina ngarang demo kyo po yong gare samne ngatsu tendri sam gare.
So one of these would be the idea that in order for my own individual happiness and satisfaction, or that I do everything, I speak words, I do my work, I undertake everything I do for the sake of my own happiness.
Then in also pena mo jamba so demo ta ke bo yong wa ga ton de ni ni sam lo tang ka ja sha de ni jamba demo ke bo yong wa ga ton de le ka sha wa drip tin di she na ni jamba so la demo ke bo yong yong tin di drip thap ko de ma to ba nga rang demo ke bo yong ko ma re sam ni tin di jamba so demo ke bo yong ko re ma to nga rang yong ko ma re sam ba ma so mo mang bo la tin di sam sri yoris.
And then many people think that by doing things, in undertaking all that we do for the sake of others, the result of that is only that others will receive happiness and enjoyment, not that we will ourselves.
Then samlo ti norwa chimbo chigre ndu se ngoni tane de deske ngoma ta kane yong ndu se na pela ngarang so mo jamba chola tini demo ke bo yong ya ga tini gandi yong sare samlo ta mo jamba cho demo ke bo yong ya ga tini kaja shet mo jamba cho demo ke bo yong ya ga shawa le ka lena tarzo tinane teni ngarang demo ke bo ngoma ta tinane yong ndu se.
But this idea is really, really wrong. In actual fact, true happiness and genuine happiness comes from thinking about how to bring others happiness, doing everything that we do, undertaking actions and words, everything to bring them happiness. This is from where we will achieve real happiness.
Then there was a good thing in our answer, what in our own la Gurmu Mombo Yopata, the Nikamba Yakboyo, Lankor Yakboyo Yagatonda, Naranga Samlotan, Lekale, Kajavsha, the Nimambo and Jamanda Lekalini, the Nushini, the Ningajima, the Nihalipa, Longshut, the Mambo Yosona, the Ningadimokiboyon Doris, and then at the Tendisam Giori, Mambo Tendisam Gioris.
So many people think that really it's by having all the things that they need in their material lives, by being very rich, by having a fancy house, etc., that this will be the genesis of their own happiness.
Then is samlo te anora renduze tela teni nguni tane ngatsu demo chepo yongo menduze tata mambo wa hako yores.
But of course this is mistaken, and actually these days there are a great many people who really realize this.
Then di yinti ngatsu lobta chimo mambo zit pe na amarga lota mambo ta wan zambala la shikin yores.
In the world today, American universities have great influence in other countries in the wider world.
Then he lota chim bo to so na ne then he mo then di rang ton tak tak la samlo ta ma to ba jan ton la samlo ta mishin ken then he kwaran so then he la pa ha chang then he tang mo rig pa tham mo then he le kan ram le go na le shin ken yin na samlo te rang do tak tak ma to ba jan la samlo ta mishin ken then he mang bo zhi ke chang she jang na din zambalang la nop kare da phang kare zina hale ba lab ka mo re ka bo re.
So given the influence and impact that American universities have on the wider world, if students and academics at American universities are really only thinking about deploying their skills and knowledge to selfish ends, then this will have a very negative impact on the greater world.
Then in Maung Pana Ngatso, then in Zambolang, then in Yargin Romotota, Yagbozu Yongmoyong, then in Tarta, ngatso lobda chimbo ti nani chang zambo lang la shikin chimbo yong kong ko tini lobda chimbo ko nana yong kong ko lobma tiso la rakle gres ma ong ba de gandhi rindu.
Really, the future direction that our society, our world society at large will take really rests and relies on this current generation of university students in influential universities and what they decide to do.
Tini mo tiso samlo ta gandhi rindu tini korang zian la samlo tangkeng ko tini zianpen then you some lo chance reta yana koran jang tang tang la sam lo tang kin tinz ren ro to lob ta ga lo so la thung do res.
And whether this generation of university students will decide to commit their lives to the benefit of others or rather to their own selfish ends hinges on the education in these universities.
Then you ending as sam nge sam lo tang ba yana ga so lob ta chin bo nam ga nang la deni mi semkam yarge so tonga ga tabsi semkam yarge so tonga ga deni lobjung ta lobchen lobchit deni yo pa de hale pa kar chim bores.
So for this reason I'm of the view that in universities today courses on the need to or the courses on improving the mind, developing the mind and training the mind are of utmost importance.
Deni mi samlo yarge tonga ga deni tabsin do so tamshe bo shir tambo gani yongwa rezina ngatsu chulu gani yongba res.
These methods that we can apply to training and improving the mind in originality are derived from religion.
In the Tambu, you know, Chulukanani Yumbareta, you know, Tatanga Solota Chimbo Mambo Nalatini Chulukzina, Yantini Chuluk Momatini, the Yung Chosa, Machosa, Namanatsundam Mambundus.
However, in terms of the secular university context today, there are, you know, all kinds of prohibitions about the extent to which religion can be brought in.
Tani tata nga tsu tini to chuluk tang chupa shi ki ta tini lhota chimbo na chuluk per ma chong na te kyo yo ma reze. Nga tsu sem kam yagi su tong yi tab shi tsu tini korang chuluk tar tu shi na chok bari ta yang na chuluk tar tu ma shi ni Machine, chula tapa machine, chocolate, chula tapa menken namgion, tapshi thing as a peshushina chocolate.
But this really doesn't matter. The point is, for the sake of improving our minds, that what we need to do is, whether or not it's linked with religion or not linked with religion, it's really the methods, the practices that we need.
Pena, nyanji tavarizi, nyanji raboyena, teni tambu kanishuarizina, teni chulukanani, teni shuariz. Yena tartang atso tini tega chulugla tapa yonkinzik pesho tana chokore chulugla tapa menkinzik pesho tana chokore sizik pesho tana chokore.
A very good example of this would be compassion. Methods of training in compassion originally came from religious traditions, but these days they are being applied in university and school contexts everywhere, and they are equally applicable to people who are religious or people who are not religious. Compassion can be understood of in as being comprised of essentially two things.
Tonda tambo to kangreze na nyarje zevate ngatso zambalang to na tini moyen na da chokchak yen na da tini dumur yo sa haliba mambore ze kwaranso khashi z zaji gonji me pa da tini khashi z tini na pa da tini khashi z sem go to ni dumur da dumur jan tini mambore ze khoso go dumur da ngatso ha go je de liao je ze ha go je de tonda tambo re ze.
So the first part of compassion is the recognition, the understanding that humans and animals and in fact all kinds of living beings in the world experience suffering, whether that suffering be physical or whether it be mental in nature. In the world today, there are many examples of great injustice between humans, different humans, and between humans and other life forms.
Then, jamnyim mayim ba the yongwi gimsen the kani yongwi yores na ngaso khosu the ni dungur the mashi pi gimsen ji yongwi yores.
And in many cases, the reason for these sufferings, the reason for these inequalities or injustices is because we don't appreciate or understand the suffering of others. So, for example, the failure of extremely affluent people to appreciate the suffering of those who are poor, the failure of people who have a lot of privilege in life to appreciate the experience of people who don't, this failure to appreciate the situation of others in less fortunate positions or in situations of suffering is a great problem.
Pena ngaranso napa maim bi nerkamna nad me bi nerkamna lipo dethang im bi nerkamna tin ngaranso napa so dungur da kandri zigen asom mambo ha ko maris.
So it's like, for example, when we're in a state of robust health, in a state of not being sick, it's very difficult for us to understand or appreciate the suffering of a person who is in a state of illness.
Tani nam ha ko rezena So rang la teni nat temni mangang na la longbi ne kamna teti tazo napa dungur dakan rezin teni hako rez.
The point when we do finally come to an understanding of what their suffering is when this illness or physical suffering arrives on our own bodies, when we find ourselves in hospital or otherwise facing sickness or disease.
Tani tindi yinan dhukum mandu zete, nga tso kante go ndu zena, nga tso lipo dethang yinpi nerkabna, nga tso nan mepi nerkabna, tani mun napa tso go dungur to kante zere, samne nga tso samlo mambo tang go ndu zena.
But this isn't how it should be. It should be that while we're still in a state of health, while we're still in a good situation, that we apply ourselves to really trying to think and empathize about the situation of people who are in a state of suffering.
Tini mun napa ti so go dungar kaunti yung aso go sim go thoni samlo mambo tani tini samlo jimmo tani samlo tangza mo tani tini che yondi tini aso go tini kotso go dungar ta halipa ga saroz tini hako yung gres.
And it's really by thinking and applying our minds to, in a very meticulous and profound way, to empathizing and thinking about the suffering of others, that we will be able to arrive at an understanding.
Then it did dumber the sorrows of going in the cabinet, and so, or tati dumber the ne, Joshigo, Samji Samlo de Kiongres.
And when we do understand and appreciate this suffering, when this feeling arises in our hearts, then comes with it the desire to do something to help alleviate this suffering.
Then you rush to go some mundu kang yung kore sila nga pero na mo siyam basa ka dumur ding arang ka sim ka nala saru ko yung na tini ng sim ka nala ti matela tini dumur ti meso na sam ni ng tini sim ka nala mulum jaw kore si ta dumur ti meso na sam ni ng sim ka nala tini jewa tini jegere si.
And so what this entails is really through arriving at a really clear appreciation of the suffering of others, and on that basis, really developing a prayer and a great aspiration and wish in one's mind to be able to do something so that they will not be in this state of suffering.
Tani rewa jabni tindi shipine kamna tani ngaranga sem ganala otangi rewa jabachi po yung gumadeng ni molum jabachi po yung gumadeng ngaranga uso rokshi go ndu samne tani ngasola sambati yung gres.
And then based on this, of course, it's not sufficient for us to simply pray or to hope for the alleviation or suffering of others. It's essential that on the basis of this hope and prayer that we undertake to engage in actual, real action.
The Korang Langi, Korang the Dungur, the Mepashe go, Korang the Dungur thing, Ropashe in Sambaga Samlo Ziona, this Samlo Tila, the Ninyar Jesus.
And so, putting it succinctly, the recognition that another human or an animal or other form of living being is in suffering, and on that basis, the aspiration to undertake action to help them eliminate that suffering. These two together are what we call compassion.
Then it is some lote, Munetanisha, not if some lote in Namba Sanje Bagatini Taba Chimbo, some lotes.
This compassion that we're speaking of is derived from the Mahayana Buddhist tradition.
Yena Kuranga Nyarjiti, then he peshit Tana, then he Namba Sanje Bala Kurantaba Shina and Chokore.
However, these practices of arousing compassion, and indeed your own compassion, the use that you put it to, it doesn't matter if you are Buddhist or not. You can be, but you don't have to be.
Ngarang namba sangji pa jigyen, ngarang namba sangji pa loma yen, ngarang namba sangji pa chupa zhigyen, samba ti.
Really, whether one is a religious, is a Buddhist follower or Buddhist practitioner, someone who has faith in the Buddhist doctrine, this is really a question quite apart from the practice of compassion.
Then in Yarjin, that in the Terang Arounds of Bena, Ishulu, Lataba Shinkan Zinanda, Muslim Chulu, Lataba Shinkan Yananda, and Tilijan Bagapena, Koran.
So practices directed to engendering and increasing compassion are things that anyone, regardless of whether they're Christian, they're Buddhist, they're Muslim, they're atheist, can all apply.
Yena 삽시드 가나 요르즈나 가조페나 뭐 띠디 냐르지 맹켄즈글라 띠니 냐르지 요바 냐르지 메바니 냐르지 요바다 띠니 냐르지 테요 공네 공든 페르와 띠디 존드르시아가 탑시드 가나 요즈나 띠 남바산지바 탑바 침보나라 탑시드 요레스.
But the method, the way of bringing a person from a state of not having compassion to having compassion and then moving on to increase the quality of the compassion, these methods and practices are from the Mahayana Buddhist tradition. But when we're talking about the efficacy of these practices, it's not like supplicating a Buddhist deity or expecting some kind of intervention from an outside force. These are really practices that one puts into practice oneself, and through committing oneself to them diligently, obtains results on this basis. This compassion doesn't have any relation to an outside god or some kind of outside deity or other kind of force that is in some way conferring this compassion on us. It's literally generated through the practice of recognizing another's suffering and on this basis developing a heartfelt aspiration to eliminate or reduce that suffering.
Nyarji gomluk tatini namba gna na shwa pi thapsi tim dordi zu shine samala ngot zu jigyens.
And I just like to go on from here and give everybody a brief introduction to the actual practice of compassion in Buddhism.
Tani tambo kandi che go re ze na nga so mug tani mon mchobo mon napa tani mo tani dumur yo sa tani yen nda yana pe na nga so
So the practice that I'm going to talk to you about tonight is one where we, with our own eyes, with our own naked eyes, we fixate on an object of great suffering, whether this be a person who is extremely poor, a person in a state of great destitution, or an animal, for example, who might be in a slaughterhouse and undergoing great suffering and pain. In the ordinary course of our lives, we often find ourselves recoiling at the sight of things that are unpleasant or painful. But what we need to do in cultivating our compassion is really compel ourselves to face these things and look at them.
Or
at the same time, aside from, you know, really casting our eyes on scenes or sights of suffering, we also need to listen compassionately. So attune ourselves to, or really listen very intently and deeply to accounts or stories of suffering, whether they be from the historical past, or whether they be things that we hear in the media, in the news, or things that other people tell us.
Or
Of course, it's quite common, it's almost routine in every day for us to hear stories about airplanes plunging into the ocean and people dying, or millions of people perishing in an earthquake. However, for the most part, we tend to dismiss these stories as, or just register them in a very superficial way. Today, this many people died. Oh, yesterday, that many people died. And the reason that we dismiss them so easily is because we're really not thinking properly.
So
what we do need to do in terms of thinking properly is say upon hearing about an airplane that has fallen into the ocean, we need to think, what if among those 250 people, one of them was me?
Yana, ne ama, ne apa, or tenjis to tina la yoni tenite shisona kandi and sari, chicta, tina ga manijada ngapchi, natina ne chicta, naranga pada, naranga mayena, kandi and sari, sani samlotangores.
Or what if one of those people were my mother or my father?
Or
my daughter or my son. Or in terms of an extremely ill person or animals that are facing slaughter. Similarly, we need to really think very deeply, what if I were one of them?
So, or
in terms of animals facing death at the in this situation, what if one of them were my mother or my father, who for the entire duration of their life has really done nothing to hurt another person, and yet despite this, this is essentially the treatment that they are receiving. What if that were the case, that it were me or my mother or my father?
Then I was going to say, I'm 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 going to say.
Or in terms of the, you know, many wars that are waged in the world every day, what if one of the person who was to die in these wars was me, or a war in my hometown, what if it were me, or my mother, or my father, or one of my family members? And in people who experience great hunger and destitution and suffering in everyday society, similarly, what if it were me or one of my family members? And by really thinking about this in a very deep and profound way, then we generate a feeling of fear.
And
this fear, which is a recognition of others' suffering, is the first stage of compassion meditation.
Nga mare ta yena an janja rezi, janja re ngarang sonda ngay dungur mendo pa jinda korang yang dungur ndo kemare, nga yinna nga rang deva yona gawa jin de tini khorang deva yona ga gre nga son dan re je nga terang tini sak mandu tini jim mandu nam jin hong rong gen mati na la nga mandu ta yinna tini nga son dan re samne tini samlo tang go re te kompani pa de re.
And the second stage of this contemplative meditation is moving on from our recognition of another suffering, the awareness that we are not that person, that today we are not in a state of great hunger or distress or facing the threat of being killed. And in really registering this awareness, we need to also keep in mind the basic equality of all people, the fact that just as I wouldn't want any of these things to happen, neither does the people who are in this situation want this to be happening to them.
Tani nga rang tsu zambolang ga tini mo changma la, mo chang, mo nam ga tini dong ga pakpa karo yore, nakpo yore, sero yore, pakpa ndraga ma re. Tani nga rang tsu nga rang tsu mo mambu ga lor, murg soso ga lorjin ndraga ma re, murg soso ga gyabjong ndraga ma re, sharnab ga rigni ndraga ma re, yina tondaga nyi ga tola nga tsu changma ndraga re.
So in the world today, there is great diversity in terms of people's skin colors and cultures and histories and contexts and backgrounds, but there are two basic respects in which we're all the same.
Ni te kang re zena pe na ngarang tini deva yong na sam nga demo che po yong song na sam ne deva chimbo yong na ta ngarang le ga da deva chung 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 tin ji na ngarang yong na ga ge yo re te nga chung zam ba lang ge mo chang ma chi ba re.
The first of these respects is the in which we are similar is essentially our desire for happiness, whether that be a great happiness or just a little happiness in general. The desire to be happy is something that humans everywhere share.
Tani ni pa te kare zena pe na ngarang la tani dungur mayong na ga yo re dungur chembo mayong na ta lega dungur chong 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 so tani mayong na ga yo re aso li papa ge thola tini chenma chong chong zeng zhuan zhao den zhe ge bian na zu kap ye bi ne ge na de zi de zi chong chong ma zu cha ge ma da papa kap ge papa pu bi de ni de ding er da bu chong chong ma to yo ma da na zu de la ma zhe ge ni de me na nga zu ga ge yo re nga rang de ni nga rang zu ga ba jin de de ni mu cha ma de dang zha re cha ma su su la ding er me na sam ken zu ma to chi gyang yo ma re ti tong ne nga zu ram ni me re.
And the second respect in which we're all basically the same is the wish not to experience suffering, even the smallest amount of suffering, the suffering that comes from a pinprick or a thorn, feeling a thorn pierce our skin. From the smallest kind of suffering up to very great forms of suffering, we all have a basic desire not to suffer.
Tinti yinti tini nga tsum mambo zila korang la dungur mena gaga yoreta, yinna dungur yoke yores.
So everybody, despite their wish not to suffer, unfortunately has to deal with the fact that they will suffer.
Deni deva yo na sam ge yore te yena deva thub ge yo ma res.
And by the same token, even though we wish for happiness, we're not necessarily able to obtain it.
Deni tenti yendi to chama pe na ngarang la deva ma thub na dungur yo pa ta deni de dungur yo na dungur yo pa jind.
So we really need to think about the fact that just as I experience suffering from not being able to obtain happiness, so does essentially everyone else. By really developing a really strong sense of the basic equality or equalness in our experience, then we will not be able, or we won't engage in behavior for our own interests that causes suffering for others.
Then in Namgin, I want to pay now. She may be near Kabzilla, then it's Sapahajan, she may be near Kabzilla, not so cheshire them count on you. Then the name Arangan Tonga Yen Samling Sam Lotangare, not so much Tambayona, Nin Tonga Yen Samgare, then you Nin the Tongana Murgo Tilan Tongio Mare, Murgo Ti Dungar in Dorita, in a Koso Sorati, not so Sam Lotanga Marze, Narangan Aranga Soratila San Lotani, Nin Tongo Samniti Samgioris.
quite often, say on an extremely hot day when everybody is feeling parched and there's one bottle of water to drink, we will be thinking about quenching our own thirst and won't be necessarily paying much attention to how others are feeling thirsty like ourselves.
Di jingsen de kare ngare ngarang la ten di samlo ngi chi shir tam kan da chama ngin thong ge yong samne ngi dagbo ja go wi samlo da gani shong re zena ni ngarang rang chi bola samlo da jan la samlo ma dang wi jingsen ji res.
And the reason that in this situation we would be thinking about ourselves and not about others is this habituated tendency to be thinking in this way about ourselves and not casting our minds to others.
Ya garti ti ne kamna nga sung ne jan la dang jab ne ong nga kom gundu dungur yong gundu da jan la yang dungur yore samji ti samlo ta ta na otni ta nge chikshir tum ka gana ne kham bo gang thong jire te win thong ma re jan ba ta jan la nge jin gres.
If I were used to or practiced in thinking about others aside from myself, then in such a situation, I wouldn't take more than one mouthful. I would offer the rest to others. In the future, the world's resources are becoming increasingly diminished.
Rando tsapo tendi mata tak tendi sorchong chejo ta tendi zambo lang mo tsama rando chen chen do res.
And if the people in today's universities are becoming or are extremely selfish in their interests, then this is how the rest of the world will become.
Tendi chi ta tendi ma ong ba nan zambo lang tong kong chis chi bo deri ti tola tsama go tso ba ja tendi zambo lang mo diwa yang yong res.
And if this is how things will proceed, then in the future the scarcity of resources will become something that people are engaged in great conflict over.
Then nga chu example on jibdi yong go zin nga chu khambut china te pan thoyo maris khambut example on jibdi yong go zin nga chu bon bo pa china te yong go maris pan thoyo maris.
So just saying or throwing around slogans like world peace, this in itself won't do it. In fact, the gradual step-by-step work towards world peace is something we need to engage in.
And this
work towards world peace is not something that we should just do with our words, but something we really need to do in terms of our working on our minds.
Rang la yang dang jak go re ta mang chi wa ta yang ge de ni dung la dang ja pa tin ji nga cho lo jong shi jang na de ni nga cho go o de ni thong khong go thong la cho pa ja yang da ta ti cho mang bu yong go ma res.
And in terms of this work on our minds, part of it is obviously working on ourselves, but the greater part is really working on thinking about others. And if we're really able to do this, then it will yield benefits in terms of future conflicts over world resources.
Garde nga chola chuluk la tapayo na pe na tini namba sang je ran do boy na nyang jin di thola tarung ti kong la yar mambo jamba mambo jondar mambo yores.
If we are Buddhists, for example, beyond the kind of meditative contemplation technique I've introduced tonight, there are of course lots of levels and stages beyond this.
Tini chuluk nyamle mershin kan sigin na te jamba ti go mare khorang chi po nyar ji chi po ti gom ni jang na te ti to ni gom na ta ndu kres.
But if a person is not Buddhist, for example, then just sticking with the basic practice of compassion is itself enough.
Deni nga zo tari kong na dang ne jamba ge tini ne tini pe na tini dumur nyong kan da ngarang yen na ngarang ka phama yen na samba to shong di Dedi halipa ga chora chimbo su shung gore di ka sim jamnyim yin sam ge ta tini gomba ni pa re tini gomba sim ba de gare zena tini o ta nga chu sam man jamnyim re te yin di tini ngarang ge dewa ga ton da la tini jamba la tini dungmur ta ya ta jamba la no pa she ya tin jug ma re sam ba ga tini sam lo ta tini ge gre s gomba sim ba te la te ki yong gre.
Okay, so now we're going to move on to the third stage of the compassion meditation or contemplative practice. After we have first recognized the suffering of others, And secondly, established a view of equality where we see that this suffering, desire to avoid suffering and to obtain happiness is something that everybody shares, and that on this basis it is not okay for me to do something for my own happiness or selfish interest that is at the expense of another's happiness.
Tiyindi tangi zhambalangi dungur mepaga chukshiga yingi rubashiga yin samji samlote shikchimbote yungarezi tikarsa.
So at this point we generate an extremely powerful aspiration to do things, to undertake action to eliminate or reduce the suffering of others.
Tini ti koranga tini taga gumsirka tini rumba thama deri gumba samba deris.
And this third stage is the final stage of the practice.
Deni nga chu gum jamni tindi samlo go thola yakbo shong sarti deni nga chu shiso go thola lekha da ngus nga chu chowa ga na la lekha da leong gre ji sim go thola tindi indi yong sarti deni jamba la phando ya ga lekha da nga so ga ja sha na ya la phando ya ga ja sha lekha le na ya la phando ya ga lekha da le gre.
And after we've completed the third stage of this meditation or achieved some kind of stability in this practice, then it's time for us to turn to actual action in society, whether that be benefiting each other, others through our words or being, or benefiting others through the actual deeds that we do.
Tendi yena nga zo khyamsang chik na la tendi yo so na tendi khyamsang chik de demo re ndo re ma chama chik chik de ni phansa rokba shi ni khyamsang chik de dechi dang dang ba re ndo re.
So in terms of family life, if members of a family are able to practice in this way, thinking about the situation of each other, then it will bring great happiness at the family level.
Tendi nga zo zhong chik chik na la tendi ma chama tendi re so na tendi nga zo zhong chik chik de tendi phansa chik chik la rokba shi chik chik de ni chik chik de ni ton la sam lo tang ten ri re gre ten ni gyar kap chig la yo na te re ten jam balang tham che ten ri re so na ten ma chon jam balang da de mo re ro re.
And then at the level of say a town or a city, if its inhabitants are able to habitually think about this way and contemplate each other in these ways, then it'll bring happiness and peace to that particular place. And then as we scale up, if this kind of practice can be undertaken by people in the world at large, then this is when we will arrive at happiness for everyone and world peace.
Deni ngatsu terang nyangji gongya shapati nge chamala ngotu jate hajang ka tabde bo nyonyo reze tarong tele jibcha yabo ji shigona deni thaba chimbo deni nyangji gongya ga deni pecha mambo yinji ga thola yang mambo yore atisa go thola tana deni pena shunji knala mambo yore deni shanchim ko sim deni gomsur knala mambo yore deni chama ga tela tana dinala pe mambo she yore.
So the contemplation practice on compassion that Kenpo has introduced tonight is just a very abbreviated, simple, straightforward approach that everybody can apply. In the Buddhist tradition, there are, of course, many practices on contemplation, some of them very detailed, that go into many, many stages and levels. And if people are interested in learning about them, then they should consult one of the many resources that exist on these teachings.
Deni te bog na ba sangye wa na ni nang ge yarje ge semkam ge yarje ge na ni chig re deni taron semkam ge yarje tong lu mambo mambo zun du to so tam che bo deni so so kar de rang sam lo rang deni mu ba yo na deni rang lo jong che na chok re ne te rang shapati chig nyarje chig bo de yens.
So the compassion practice that I mentioned tonight is one way that the Tibetan tradition views the development or progress of the mind. The practice that was introduced tonight is one but of many, and if you have the interest or desire, it's something that you can put into practice yourselves.
Deni yargi khsim yo pinani ni pa de kan rezena deni mo kunshu ke yargi deris mo shopa ge yargi deris.
So the first type of progress that the traditional Tibetan, in the traditional Tibetan worldview, being the development of one's mind or the progress of one's mind. The second being the development or progress of one's moral behavior and conduct.
Tini yargi sambata tini tazo pamjur ka yargi telan jokores.
And then the third type of progress would be material or economic development or progress.
Tini yargi sam ti nani kar chishu de kanrezena sem ga yargi sem kam ga yargi tela ngunzen gres.
And of these three different types of progress and development, the most important is the first one, the development of one's mind.
Tani teranga ngatsu yargiga tini kor shusog de shusog yargiga nala namba tini nipagari thongre ziki tin chatchat tani tinin samjo kyen tini ngatsu jini taru shusog shekhasgla tini ngatsu jwa tinun shena chokres.
So this brings to conclusion my talk tonight about the influence of Buddhist ideas of social progress. And we've got another half hour or so remaining, and I'd welcome any questions you might have. And thank you everyone for listening.
Thank you very much. We have the microphone for questions.
I regarded the Tibetan Buddhism very highly, and I do appreciate you taught us Tibetan Buddhist teaching in a way even non-religious people can understand, can believe, can be convinced. Now, my questions, I have two questions. One is that quite a number of years ago, the Dalai Lama published a book titled called Beyond Religion. And he also said the compassion, this word. And they said the compassion can be the foundation and the core of new millennia, new centuries ethics. It can be exhibited by all the religious people and the non-religious people. That's why this book is called Beyond Religion. Beyond Religion. My question is that, have you read Dalai Lama's book? And also, you also talk about the compassion. I really appreciate. What's the relationship of the compassion you talk about it and the Dalai Lama's compassion? Yeah, that's my first question.
Da thambo de ni ke ko so chama de ni nyung je ko ko mo jo shi de ka ta ko jin che chue li ta ma yin ba de ni ko so chama kyap chung gong yin gong ni yin tu na музыка не учуше цу тени хажу я поросити тени чи там боїна тени гьор поче на ко тени чули те пе пече джибуре тени ти нала тени гьор поче ко нинджи зина пече тени маумбе тени дюра миши цаче ко нала тени чули ки кяпчун канг мун ко мецама тени килен ше тут ки тауди лунда ко тени мауши джибуре зекинду че пече ти та эмню тени ке тени тогон ко цу тени нунджи ко ко тени мучуше буре че ко нунджи та Да, я уже почти сунг нун же ди. Кепа эйо. Чиз кэ джо рейс.
Тэни тэгжи чи нэ жарам бо чэсэн кэ пэжа дэ та мам нюнс.
Thank you for your question. Kempo has not read the Dalai Lama's book.
So, thank you. But I think that what you taught us I was very, very impressed that way.
Yarar mo chesang ge pe cha tso nga tso ta go na hale pa kha bore nga mes.
For people like Kempo to have access to the Dalai Lama's books is very, very difficult. Therefore, he hasn't read it.
Yin na yang nga tso de ni nyar ji zi ya te khorang tong go thola tin di ge chulu ge jab jong ka nga me na chama ga nyan li shi na chokken 그런 동거 돌아 된 뒤지 잉그리스
However, in terms of compassion and what he's written about it, the fact that it can be practiced by anybody, irrespective of their religious tradition, is in fact true.
Okay, thank you. So thank a second question I will not ask.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I withdraw it. Mm-hmm.
So I guess I have a two-part question too. I wrote down, thinking only about ourselves is a habit. In what, if so, one, did I write that down right? And then two, how is that, it seems like that's in conflict with a lot of Western thought about need, a basic need being not habit, but a part of nature. And would he comment on that, please?
That's the first question, yeah?
First question, did I write it down right? Mm-hmm. That thinking about ourselves is only a habit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then how does that compare to some of our Western notions of thinking of ourselves first as a need?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
So, according to the Buddhist tradition, humans are seen as having two kinds of need. The first kind of need is that which arises or that which we intrinsically have upon the moment we're born into the world, so a very fundamental, basic kind of need. And then the second kind of need is the need that we are educated into or have inculcated into us through our socialization in the societies in which we live. The roots, basically, of this perceived need is something, if we're going to change, is extremely, extremely difficult. However, through relentless training, it is something that we are able to modify. The Buddhist tradition does consider itself to have ways to completely change or to completely, to change the nature of this need. However, this is an extremely high level of practice. It's an extremely high aspiration too. However, in terms of the lives that we lead in society and in the world today, it's really not possible to change this need entirely. And what you say is true, there are times when we do need to think about ourselves. However, in addition to thinking about ourselves, it's really important that we commit more energy to thinking about others. For example, in terms of our everyday lives, 30% of energy is devoted to our own needs and 70% devoted to others.
Yeah. Thank you.
I have a one-part question.
You mentioned earlier that 45% of college students roughly suffer from some sort of depression. What do you think would be a good thing for a college student in that situation to do?
That's
a very important question. Thank you for asking it.
아니 동서 그나 용근지게 남 네서 간디 군이 줄고지나 네서 니인데스 줄거니 인데스
So there are first of all two situations here.
아니 동서 그나 때 인 랑부 레네 되니 할리바가 되니 다 자마자마 또 바다 니모용와다 되니 할리바가 되니 친보 된디리 찬근스다 되니 다주 군 된디가 친보레 마찬네 다주
The two situations would be a person who has suffered from depression for a long time, their symptoms are severe, they can't sleep, they don't want to eat, they're really afflicted very, very seriously by it. And then the other situation would be a person who's really starting to be afflicted by the symptoms. If a person who's in relatively early stages of depression, then applying techniques of meditation can help them to completely cure themselves of the disease to such an extent that medication or taking medicine is not necessary. And this is something that people have experience in doing meditation, particularly meditation on calm abiding can really yield very clear and immediate benefits for people with early stage depression. And for those who are in a pretty severe situation or who have suffered depression for a long time, then to begin with, they would do well to take medicine to at least bring their symptoms under immediate control. However, after the symptoms have been brought under a kind of control, it's important for them then to really start to meditate. Continually existing on medication is not the way to go. And this is results based on experience.
I really liked your point on how survival is not the main purpose for living, that there has to be something beyond that for it to actually matter. What is the purpose, would you say, behind our survival? Like you talked about, do you think it's the compassion that you were talking about, or is there something more?
Mm-hmm.
所以，So the purpose of survival is clearly not just survival in itself, but beyond that, there are many levels of what the other thing could possibly be.
所以，忙不人得，但是说。
However, if we put them all together, then I suppose it's possible to speak of two things. The first of these things would be one's own self-development.
And
So this would be a matter of engaging in contemplative and meditative practice, and through this.
Then,
And compassion that you spoke of is one of the practices that we could apply to this development or enrichment of ourselves. So even though the scientific endeavor has revealed a lot about the external material world, really the most amazing and the most amazing world is that which resides in our own minds. So whether we talk about it as the power or the potentiality of our mind or of our brain, regardless of how we decide to conceive it, there is so much vast potentiality that exists inside of us, and ways and means of really accessing or enabling this potentiality is something that the Buddhist tradition has a lot of techniques and methods in respect of. Whereas our bodies really are quite limited in the extent to which we can enhance them or develop them. Up until a certain point, we'll start to regress, we'll start to get old, we'll start to become weak. The mind, by contrast, is something that there is a very great capacity and space to improve. And then the second meaning of survival beyond survival would be that of benefiting others, benefiting people in the community, being of help and assistance and service to others.
So the mind is a big part of the talk you gave. So in your opinion, what is the ideal mind, and how would one achieve that?
In terms of the Buddhist system of psychology, the different stages or level of the mind are characterized as 8.
Dini get di nala ngaco soa nala dini namgin ngaco soa nala yungkendu gak nani dente.
And of those relating to our everyday lives, there are 7.
Tani dung nani ngatsu namjin tini tata ngatsu yapo ta dupo la tini shapa jaya lojong shia tashin shia tisu tini leka lengkendu tini jigba tiris jigba diliu.
And the 6th of these stages is that those areas of our life in which we engage in all kinds of endeavors, research, study.
Tani gyapa ta kang reze na korang ngachun chua ga nala namgi yungo marita yena tani korang tani di namshi tamchi pogo tani gyabla ze na mangji ngomanda ta korang reze.
This 8th level that we're talking about is something that we can't readily perceive, but it's the basis, it's the back of everything, it's our consciousness.
Then chigtang aso chigpa tela tini girchu jab gore jondre shini ta nge tari kone yar jib she gore ji ta chigpa tela yar jib she gore chigpa
and the kind of improvement or progress that I was speaking about tonight was really in the sixth of those levels, the one that relates to study and endeavor and improvement of ourselves in that way.
Tini chigpa ta yar ji tong ji ta girchu jab ji ta te ts samore zeng aso lojong she ne rentang ka ta par gir ni tri she ji ta samba zambo yong ya tere ta te te ts samore le la bore is
and it's relatively easy for us to get results in this sixth level by studying or improving our attitudes and understandings and views
deni gir chu jap go yang ngo ma ta tini nga cho ti japa tris japa de gir chu jap go res.
However, it's really this eighth level that ultimately requires our efforts.
Deni gyapat gum gyamne deni gyechu gyapje ma tonga so samlo ndishi ndishi gyerwa tamji deni phantha yo mare so gum gyamne deni yaje jondr tang gores.
And this eighth level of is something that if we are wanting to see transformation of, we really need to engage in meditative practice. It's not something that we can experience change in by applying discursive thought or normal thinking practices.
Deni gyapati nang la korang la tang la ni bi ni ba mambo qian zai de neng liang neng ling neng li tang na yo bi ni ba mambo yo re gum gyam na ti tang na yo bi ni pa te so chang bo shi la yong re.
And it's on this eighth level that we can really access and release all kinds of latent potentialities that our minds have.
Zo de korang de ni ti na ne her zhi hui de yar ji sen zhe wo re de yar ji de yar ji nachi ji dian ze dele pan ro ji me ji de song na de ni sang ji ze ge res.
And it's what we're this latent potentiality that we are seeking to generate or arouse at this level is a kind of wisdom, and when this reaches its apex, then from the Buddhist point of view, we talk about having attained Buddhahood or awakening.
De ni ti yar ji tang shi tang tang ji ge tab shi de zo tam ji bo nang ba ge zhong ge nang la yo re su su reng ge sim ge nang la mu si dang si ge na nyam lin shi na chuo ya din zhi re ma to ba de shen mi zhu yi din zhi zi zha ni ma re zi ko rang ha le ba ge de ni sar wu re zi.
And the steps or the methods that a person, regardless of anyone, can apply to reaching this state is in no way mysterious, it's in no way mythical, it's something the Buddhist tradition describes in very clear and methodical steps. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I very much appreciate your sharing this evening. I wanted to ask a question in reference you were talking about earlier about the stages of awareness of others' suffering. And I wonder how does one, if you become aware of others' suffering, how do you not embody that suffering yourself? I mean, how do you not become overwhelmed in thinking about that? I know taking action is perhaps one way, but you can't always take action. So how do you protect yourself, I guess, so that you can continue being aware?
Da deni nong je ge bi ka se da chang san deni mi shen bo ko deni dong a deni ha bo sa jo se tu mu zun xie na da rong so so ge dong a mon bo yong ge de ti ka se deni chang san ina ha jin dong su che bo yong de da rong so so da kan de da po xie ko re chang san ina dong a mang su su ina da kan de xie ko
ya ti cho rong ge de zhe ha jin gar chin bo zhe se.
This is an important question.
Deni zhang ge deni dungur la samlo mambo mambo tana rang sim deni machi pa deni yang yong gres.
It is possible that by thinking about or a lot about another suffering that one will feel suffering oneself.
Deni chapar tanga cho deni shirtang jang ge dungur mambo la ta mambo la sam deni shi ni deli deli jamba ga ta shi me na deni sim ge na la du bo yong gre deni sim da bo jab go na kamo yo res.
And if all we're doing is really sitting there thinking about another's suffering and feeling quite worried about it, and we don't have any means or methods beyond this at our disposal, then it is true, we may feel great suffering.
Deni ti ka sa deni jan ji dumur de zon dang jam ne deni rang se ma ki pa ta tambu yong go gres te yong go re ma to te ma yong na
However, we do need this this suffering, and we do need this discomfort, this unhappiness ourselves. To begin with, we do need this because it's on the basis of having experienced this that we feel the motivation then to help others. So it's not okay that we think, well, thinking about another person's suffering will only bring me suffering, so I'm not going to think about their suffering.
And
it's through generating the desire very strongly to eliminate another suffering that one's own feeling of suffering will reduce. So it's through generating this desire to help others that that suffering or unhappiness gets converted into a kind of energy or force. But it is true that there are times when we really can't do much to help others and the scope of our capacity is limited. So there are different ways that I suppose the Buddhist tradition offers to dealing with this kind of situation, and one of them would be that realizing one can't do much to help another person at this point in time, at that particular moment, really generating a very sincere prayer or aspiration for this person's well-being. But this is one way, but it's not the best way. The second and the best way is to, at the point that one realizes one at this point in time can't do much to help the other person, at this moment generate the really sincere aspiration to work on oneself and develop oneself in whatever way necessary so that one in the future will be able to help people better. And by generating this really powerful aspiration within oneself, the force of it, in fact, is an antidote for the suffering. So it's like, for example, not being in a position to be able to help people who are afflicted with a very serious disease. Though we might generate the prayer or aspiration that this, the people be relieved of the disease, or the strength of the prayer by itself might probably won't be enough. However, if at that point we really generate the aspiration to go and learn how to treat people who are ill with disease and to really go straight away and work on our skills and capacity, then this will give us a sort of a confidence that will be a very effective countermeasure to our own suffering.
Thank you. I have sort of a follow-up question that she just asked. Is simply, how do you practice your compassion for, you know, for the Chinese government and their efforts to try to stamp out the Tibetan culture and customs and things like that? It's just an example of how you practice compassion in that type of situation.
Ni kempo kerang soso ke dini da nyongje ke dini da kumtop ke kola juri jubere da jana ke nala dini jana ke sungku dini wo ke sa jadi rikli mebu soya ke dini da ke mambu jubere dini ti koyu ke nala ke nyongje kandas ke
shirtang dini ngarang ke ju nyangji gumgu yore zi ngatso namjin dini ngatso taba chimbo ke dini nyamlin shinkan zigen na tini nyanji gumgu yore tini nyanji gumgu na tini perna simchen thamshe pola tini nyanji gumgu re perna mahayana thamba chenpo yina tina la nge perna ndela gumgu yinze wata ndela gumgu munze wata tini tinti ka yewa chichi yo ma re tsangma la tini gumgu re tini tsangma gumgu re.
So in general, in terms of Mahayana Buddhist practice, it's, you know, not a question of exercising compassion to this person or not exercising compassion to that person. An intrinsic part of the practice is the fundamental equality of everybody. And it's this that forms the basis of the practice. Specifically on the question of compassion practice in respect of the Chinese government, but this is a question that bears on politics, and Kemble's sorry that he's really not in a position to answer.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
I think we have time for one more question.
There are those of us who meditate regularly and know the benefits of it. And then there are those in our lives who we see experiencing dissatisfaction or suffering, and meditation would be a way for them to alleviate this. And how do you communicate that to them in a way that compels them to practice rather than say, oh, I know how to meditate, I'll do that later? How do you communicate to someone that it really will benefit them in the now?
Halipagatini, Shikan Jambo, Tini, Tindi Yabos, Resona, Tini, Kakaze Gomare, Koranga, Chut, Nama Chutinti, Tindi, Shika, Tindi, Jombo, Tindizian, Tachu Gari Resonsena, O Nagum Jamni Rezivana, Tini, Tashi Yashutiris.
Probably the best way would be really the fruits of one's own practice. So, for example, a person who once had a great temper problem and was frequently criticizing other people or saying things that caused other people to feel upset, and then through meditation, really transforming one's behavior and one's personality, allowing other people to witness these changes and enabling them to see that these are the results of meditation is probably the best way of communicating the benefits of meditation to them.
Do dinishana ngarang rang pena ngarang rang gum jamni rangye ke thola phamba yo pate jan la dini tung go re ti jang ge tin thong sona dini jang ge tri khelen ro re ti yakshu tri.
So putting it simply, it's really demonstrating the manifest benefits of meditation to others, and this is the best way of communicating.
Deni ni pa tang a cho rugby jong le ko tone deni sem ge tola na cha yong wa ge gim chen da deni gim chen de kan di tach chu she go cer da de tach chu she cer de deni gom ge na la yo cer de so rug pa ge tone par yak bo gim chen deni ni lig tang tang ba zu sha na de ge yang pan to yong yong ge de gu.
And it's also benefit. It's also of benefit to communicate with them the textual, you know, logic and reasoning behind meditation. How the mind works. How mental affliction is. You know how it arises. How meditation can benefit. It's also benefit to share this kind of reasoning with people too.
Then you gum the jamna. Ngaso soso rang. Then you gum jam kengko the same kanala. Then you. Chorwa ramada mambu yungare chorwa halepa yakbo mambu yungare te chorwa demo ta kebo ta tini nangdon chan donda yo pa tini dondang dam ba tini chorwa mambu yungare ta yina ta ti par khagsha guna halepa khabores.
Of course there are lots of benefits from meditation in terms of all kinds of positive feelings and states that meditation can engender, but quite often to communicate these to others in language is rather difficult.
Thank you all very much for coming. Please join me one more time in thanking the Kenpo.